Is that it up there? Is this it?
I don't know, man. We're just gonna have to find out. Whoa.
Holy shit, dude.
Am I drinking right now? Yes. Yes, motherfucker. I am drinking right now.
You should give me a promotion for how clever this fucking, how much yeah, work
dude,
I put into this.
How much work I put into being able to drink on the job.
Butter.
Like, nope, this is my job. Like, let me just fucking take these people out.
What about Bassam, dude?
Banana mobile.
Okay, and then the girl saying, I'm only laughing because you're laughing. I'm like, yeah.
You're telling me I need a colonoscopy now.
The proctologist. I like to get real high when I go to the zoo.
Are flamingos on the endangered species list?
I love that he committed real hard to the bit and also has a small penis. Oh, don't fuck up. Hey, don't fuck up. I've been very nice about it because I'm not mad. But you're starting to get... You're starting to...
Oh, man. Apollo, what's going on? Peanut Dream, what's going on?
What's up, guys?
What's happening? Welcome to Blue Skies from the Basement. My name is Austin. Joining me, as fucking always, is my best friend, the Savage Dad, and him fucking self. Oh my god, what's up, Dad?
What's up?
What's up, Dad?
What's up?
And we got my beautiful, beautiful partner over there. But sadly, two of our microphones have crapped on themselves, so she is not going to have a mic today, which I'm really sad about. But she's just going to be hanging out with us and probably interjecting at different times. We'll try and, you know, pick her up whenever we can. But, yeah.
Our sound is off?
Your sound is off. We can't. Oh, I see that, actually.
Oh, man. There we go.
Hey, yeah, you can hear us now, right?
Yeah. Hey, don't worry, guys. We're professionals. We know what we're doing 100% of the time.
Jeez, man.
It's all good, dude. It's been, what, 4 weeks since we did this?
It's been 1 week
since you looked at me. It has been.
Oh, my gosh, dude.
I didn't check my sound levels for this, so I also fucked up.
Oh, jeez.
Yeah, it's okay.
Well, welcome to our... Oh.
Yeah, that sounds terrible.
Welcome to our extremely professional podcast here.
Yeah, yeah.
As much as a drunk English girl can understand you. Oh, dude. This is gonna bother me. My mic keeps, like, sliding down because the thing's not tough. Man, it's gonna be a crazy show. So, yeah, we've been gone for 3 weeks now.
Yeah. Well, we played It Takes Two last week.
But I'm talking like podcast.
Yeah.
This is like, this would be week number four, right?
Yeah.
Like,
yeah, so this is week four.
We've been gone for like a month from recording the podcast because you went on your girl's trip and then...
Before that.
Huh?
Before that was your...
Oh, yeah. Before that was my 12-hour stream. Then you went on your girl's trip. Then...
My wife was out of town.
Your wife was out of town. And then we did... That's when we did the It Takes Two stream. So, yeah, this is the fourth. We've been gone for a month. That's crazy.
It is crazy.
Holy shit.
One of the longest breaks we've ever taken from doing this.
Oh, yeah. I think it was cool, though. Like, it was like, somewhat needed, you know? I think that it was nice to take, like, that long of a break. But we were still, like, hanging out and shit. So. Yeah. That was nice. Like, there's no way I could go a month without seeing you.
Yeah.
Fuck, I hated doing that shit before. And then we go to, like, seeing each other every fucking week, and now... And then... Yeah. No. No!
Yeah.
No!
Hey. What the fuck are you doing?
What do you mean, what the fuck am I doing?
Where are the episodes?
Oh. Honest needs to get her man in check. What's with the late uploads? I'm running out of episodes to watch over and over. Go listen to the audio episodes, then.
I think he did, and he's just he re-listens and re-watches stuff, man. He wants it all.
That's crazy. So you've listened to all 60-something episodes, Apollo?
Almost all of them.
Ooh.
Oh, well, fuck
appreciate
you.
It.
I liked you until now. I was gonna.
Her mic might is off. She doesn't have one. What I was saying when we were muted was that two of our microphones crapped out on us, so we don't have, we're missing two microphones now. One of them is my fault, for sure. I might have punched it a few times, but,
you battered the one mic, and then when you put them away in the case next to each, or in the tub next to each other, the battered mic was talking to the still alive mic, and it offed itself, it didn't have to go through that.
It wasn't even in the box, they were sitting next to each other on my desk.
You did have the two mics set up for the streams.
That's what I have to do for now, and, yeah, and then the second one, I mean, we've had them for over 2 years, and they are, like, $40 mics, so, we can't complain, like...
They sound great.
No, they sound awesome, but it's whatever, you know?
It didn't stop?
I threw my phone across the room, but it didn't break.
It didn't slow to a stop?
What?
I'm just being a grammar jerk.
Hold on.
I'll wait for you to catch up.
Oh, it didn't break. Okay, I see. I get it now. I get it, but it didn't stop. Oh, man.
You threw your phone and it didn't stop? So it just kept going?
So speaking of like a dad joke, I was at work the other day and this dude came up and talked to me. And was telling me about how these carpenters, like, were putting up drywall, but instead of putting, like, the last two pieces up, so, like, this finisher could, like, put the mud up and stuff, they were, like, started to, like, clean up and stuff. And so he was like, hey, can you guys, like, put that up there? And they were like, we don't have the measurement for it.
Yeah.
He's like, your carpenters get the measurement, put it up there.
Yeah.
What do you mean? And I guess they took offense to it, and one of the dudes was like, go fuck yourself. And he was like, if I had a dick long enough, I would. But if it's like that, I'll go get a tape measure and measure it for you, and, like, I'll do it.
That's what I was going to say. Is like, you don't even need to be a carpenter to measure things. You can just grab a tape measure. What the fuck is wrong with you?
So after he told me that... they had like a lift outside, and I was going to go take some 2x4s out, and they were down on the ground, so it was kind of like in my way, because like I stacked them on top of a dumpster and was like pushing it out, and it was just a little too tall. So there's two guys, and there's one guy that's in the basket, one side out on the outside, and he like sees me, and the other guy that's in the basket that controls, you know, the basket and everything doesn't see me, and he's like, hey, you're in that guy's way.
Yeah.
So he turns around, and he's like, oh, man, go fuck yourself. Like, just joking around, you know. Like, okay. It was completely, like, yeah, let me, you know, context this. Okay. Just joking around, like, and I could tell, you know, and I immediately was like, well, if I had to dig long enough, I would, and it made him laugh, and like, it was all cool and everything, and I was like, it's funny that with him he was saying it with like a bad interaction, but with me it was like I just might have like I just got cool with these guys real quick, you know.
Yeah, well, it's the same exact joke, different person, different context.
Yeah,
and it's also like you don't get to do fucking good callbacks very often in life where like it's actually funny, where you can be like, call back. Like, yeah, that's fucking great.
I had to go up to the finisher and tell him, like, hey, man, I just used that. I just want to let you know. Like, I definitely got that from you, and I literally just used it and made these guys laugh. So,
I stole your joke.
Tell him what the finisher does. Tell him what the finisher does?
What's his job?
Oh, he spreads the white mud all over the wall. Literally, I was telling her about this earlier, and she was just making sexual innuendo jokes like one after the other. I was like, can you stop? I'm trying to tell you a story.
It's spreading white mud around the room.
It's the sexually problematic evil twin of the Punisher.
Yeah. Oh, geez.
If the Punisher is problematically violent, the Finisher is problematically coming all over the place.
The Punisher goes in first, and then the Finisher goes in to finish, right?
Yeah.
So that's like, you know, the white mud. And aftercare, the Finisher cuddles with you after the Punisher.
All I can think is, because I was raised on Mortal Kombat, is Finisher.
Oh, God, dude. Dude was kicking my ass in Mortal Kombat last night.
Oh, you were playing some Mortal Kombat?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. But I've never played Mortal Kombat before.
Oh, really?
And so he was like, oh, you know,
Like, which one were you playing?
The new one.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Yeah, and...
Weren't you...
What?
Talking shit? Oh, yeah. That you were gonna kick his ass.
Oh, yeah, no, for sure. But here's the thing, though. Here's the thing. I've never played Mortal Kombat, and so he was like, I'm gonna kick your ass in a game. I was like, okay, you know, cool. Now play me in some COD, because he had Call of Duty. Like, he had the games, and he didn't want to do it.
What about Bass of Duty? Sorry, you can take the microphone away from me.
See, this is why we have a mic for you, though.
I know. Like, this is what I'm saying. Like, I'm so upset that, like, our microphone... I'm so sorry, babe. Fuck, man. But he didn't want to play Call of Duty. Yeah. I was like, okay, yeah, you're cool. We kick my ass, but you won't let me kick your ass in a game. Like,
yeah.
Let's play some Call of Duty. Like, I'll whoop your ass in that. But it's whatever. It's whatever. I ain't mad. I don't care. I've never played Mortal Kombat.
Yeah.
I've played it like a few times in my life and was like, I suck at this. So
it's one of the weirder fighting games because it's not as like smooth or make it doesn't the like button doesn't make as much sense as like a Street Fighter.
Yeah,
like, Street Fighter, the way that I haven't played any of the recent ones, but at least like the older ones, it was like when you were doing a fireball, it would be like you were kind of pulling back and then you would push forward twice and then you would press the punch button. So it's like a pull back and then a throw and then a punch. And
right.
That would be a fireball.
Yeah.
And all the moves made Mortal Kombat's not like that at all. And it also kind of feels like there's like a little tiny bit of delay between when you do a thing and when the character does it because of the way it's animated.
Oh, dude.
Yeah. They're great though.
Because the fireball is like left, right, square.
Yeah.
And so I'd be fucking doing that and nothing would happen.
Yeah.
You just punch. And I was like, am I doing this wrong? Am I doing like the left and right too slow? Or am I doing it too fast? Like, what the fuck is going on here? Like, I know I'm doing it. Like, I'm using the D-pad too. So like, I know that like I'm doing left, right, square. Yeah. So what the fuck is going on?
It feels way more like entering a password to do a trick. Or like a move, then it does feel like doing the fucking move.
I don't like it.
Yeah.
Nope.
I grew up on it, so like I love it. Like the Mortal Kombat movie came out, and I still haven't seen it. But we have HBO Max. I hope nobody from there is watching this. But we have a totally legit login that we got from HBO.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. And it's on there, so I'm planning on watching that because I'm like, new Mortal Kombat movie? Even if it sucks, I'm going to love it.
Same thing as like your Hulu is totally legit, too.
Oh, yeah. And yeah. Our Disney Plus is totally legit.
Yeah.
And our Netflix is totally legit.
Our Netflix is totally legit.
Oh, yeah. Our Netflix is totally legit.
I think the only real thing I have is YouTube Red, and I just canceled that recently.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Yeah.
Hell yeah.
We pay. Spotify.
Oh yeah, and Spotify.
We do pay for Spotify because.
Yep. That's what me and the wife do. Same thing. I don't listen to her stuff.
Nah, that's why I rarely go to the Duo Mix. We don't do it. It's just not
she sometimes
the same type.
Will see what I'm listening to, and she'll go check it out, and then I'll do the same. Like, or she'll send me like a Spotify playlist that she's made, and then I'll go listen to that.
What's that one artist that you've been Snail Mail? She's been listening to Snail Mail a lot. Yeah. And I listen to Courtney from Work. So, like, that's it. That's, like, all you need to know. And then it's, like, the old shit, like, Mac Miller, you know, Kendrick, J. Cole, shit like that. So,
you like what you like until somebody shows you something.
Yeah. And then once they show me something, if I like it, I'm like, oh, that's all I'm going to listen to for the next, like, 3 months. Like, seriously. It's like every time I take a shower, I throw on Courtney from Work.
Yeah.
It's also nice because I like singing, too, with Courtney from Work. So.
That makes sense.
Yeah. Oh, so I wanted to talk about something with you real quick. So yesterday when I was driving to go to the restaurant, I saw on the back of this, like, I want to say it was, like, a Ford Expedition or something like that. But it said Cody's World on the back of it, like in like scripture shit. Like, I don't know. It was.
Wait, what kind of vehicle was this again?
Like a Ford Expedition.
Like a van?
Nah, it's like a truck, like a bigger SUV.
SUV?
Yeah.
Okay.
Like a four-door.
Kind of like an Escape, but the bigger version.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Yeah. And what's it say on the side?
Cody's World.
Spelled how?
C-O-D-Y-S.
Okay, at least it's not a K.
World.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Do you know anything about this? Or
no, I want to like, Google it.
Like, I mean, I was thinking the same thing, but I was driving and then kind of forgot about it. But I was like, is this just a dude named Cody that's like, this is my world. And he's like, I'm going to put it on the back of my fucking Ford Expedition.
It's got to be something. Like, it's an advertisement for something. Like, maybe they run some sort of business or it's a landscaping.
Jamie, can you look that up for me, please?
Jamie, pull that shit up.
People started calling him Joe... look that up, Rogan, or something like that.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Yo, I've loved all the people that he's been having on recently.
Yeah, like,
I've gotten back into Joe, I just got done listening to when he first went back to, or when he first went to Spotify exclusive and had Duncan Trussell on, and they went
Duncan's
for fucking 5 hours,
Duncan's
dude.
The best. Dude,
they're awesome. Like, their fucking conversations are so great. Like, yeah. I fucking love that shit. And now I'm in the middle of Miley Cyrus right now.
Oh, that was actually a fucking fantastic episode.
It's so far so great. Like, I love it. I did listen to the Demi Lovato one, and that's something that I think everybody should check out. Like,
yeah, that one was very interesting,
that
too.
That was a really fucking good one. I'm excited for the Mike Tyson one.
Yeah, yeah. Because the one leading up to when he was fighting again was intense. So have you not listened to that one yet?
Oh, no. So should I go back and listen to the one before he started fighting?
The comeback podcast that he does where he's like, I'm about to fight this guy is fucking... He talks about the training, and that's also the one where he's like, I want to kill people, and it makes me feel good.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's not the exact quote, but he says something along those lines.
I remember, I think we talked about it, or I've talked about it with somebody, but Did you find something?
So, it's either this film that came out in 2020. That's 2021.
Was it written like that?
No.
Did the person that made that live in Ohio or, like, Kentucky or something? I'm sorry, I might be asking you for... too much information.
I like your button, by the way. Way to 420.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah.
Yeah, Crystal brought that back for me, too.
Hell yeah.
I've been wearing it since 420, and I'm like, it's 420 every day.
Hey, man, you know what today is? It's 422.
The estimated budget for that Cody's movie?
Yeah.
$200.
No way. You said it was 22 minutes long? Yeah, it's a shitty movie.
But the other thing that popped up
I've seen some
is...
good short films.
Yeah.
Cody's World, Living with Autism and ME on Facebook, but it's not going to pop up for me.
Okay.
That makes more sense.
Hopefully it's that.
Yeah.
You okay there, bud?
I need to do something.
Okay. I'll give you some time.
Oh, no, you can keep going.
I can keep going?
Yeah, I'm listening.
I mean, okay. So, if it is the, you said autism? Yeah. If it's that, then cool, but if it's the... short film, I'd be like,
It reminds me of I was driving on the road over here actually one time back when we used to live over here, and it was like an old white Ford pickup truck, like one of the smaller ones, and then I had like the box frame on it, but it was like set up like it was a refrigerated section on the back of this fucking just old truck, and then it had a sign on the back that was like, you can't beat our meat.
oh my god, I know why I brought this Cody World up too.
Oh, okay.
Because I saw another one when I was on my way home from work the other day too, and it was an all-white truck, and it was like basically something along the lines of like, proud to be white, and I almost just slammed my car into it. Like, I was like, nope, this is my job, like, let me just fucking take these people out.
I get that sense from certain people when I'm driving on the highway, because I have the Black Lives Matter sticker on the back of my car, and I will see people like speed past me even if I'm in the fast lane. Like, they'll speed past me on the right shaking their head,
it's
like a dude in a dirty pickup truck, and I'm like, yeah, he hates me, he thought about fucking just veering me off the road.
You're like, fucking good, dude. Fuck you.
Yeah.
Oh, I was when we went down town for our anniversary, there was a dude, and it wasn't like, it was pretty chilly, like I was in a sweatshirt, and like the wind was going, and it was like pretty chilly. Dude is in a convertible with like a long sleeve button up shirt on, and like a vest, like a not like a coat vest, like a sleeveless, like jacket kind of thing. You know what I'm talking about.
A cummerbund or something. That's not the right word, but
you know what I'm talking about. Yeah. So he's got one of those on, and he's like got a Black Lives Matter flag. And it's like a white dude too. He's got like a Black Lives Matter flag, and he's driving around in this like nice ass red convertible, like an older red convertible. And like, so I'm like walking down the street, and he like honks at me. And like, of course, like I see the flag and everything. So I'm like, yeah. And he was like, just put his thumb up, and I was like, yeah. I don't know why. I was just like, yeah. Like,
I do kind of have questions about that, though, because he's driving around in that fucking convertible that you said a red convertible.
Yeah.
And he's a white guy dressed nice. And I'm like, you're flaunting your white privilege with the fucking Black Lives Matter flag. And also, you're driving around checking white people who are dressed kind of, because you dress nice, too. You're wearing a button up.
Oh, but I was in like a black hoodie.
Oh, okay.
And my black, like, jeans.
Yeah, it's just funny to me. I mean, fuck
yeah. I have my hood up, so, and I'm just wearing, like, skate shoes. Yeah. So, like, from the outside, I was wearing a nice shirt, though, but, like, from the outside, like, you wouldn't, from that point of view, I would just look like a fucking skate rat, basically.
Yeah.
So, but, I mean.
That's awesome still, though.
Like, I mean, I thought it was cool, you know, I wasn't, like, whatever, so, yeah.
Yeah.
Some great times. Some great times, man.
I want to see that.
Yeah.
I need to go downtown more so I can see crazy shit.
When it gets nice, we need to go skate downtown.
Yeah, for sure.
Fuck yeah, dude. Oh, on 256, you know where that CVS used to be right there in the corner when you would, like, turn into Walmart? Like, as soon as you would, like, get off the freeway or whatever, you would turn right there. It was, like, a CVS or a Walgreens, whatever used to be there.
Yeah.
So it's a urgent care. Now,
oh, okay.
Bro, the fucking stair set in front of that.
Ooh.
Fucking buttery, bro.
You know I love a good stair set.
Buttery.
Yeah.
Okay. It is pristine. I'm sure that the run-up is fucking awesome to it, and you have plenty of room, and, like, the landing is just going to be... I passed by it, and I was like, if I could skate stair sets, I would get out of my car right now. Like, yeah. But I can't, so...
There's a bunch of spots where I'll be like, is my board in my car? As I'm, like, driving by, I'm like, I can't right now.
I keep mine in my car, dude.
Yeah.
Which is bad, because once it starts to get hot, it'll fuck the grip tape up again.
Yeah, it's kind of okay when it's cold, but...
Yeah. Yeah, I don't want to do that. I don't want to fuck it up again. What? What were you going to say? Oh!
Is my mic doing it now, too?
No.
Or is that just my headphones?
I think it's just your headphones, okay, bud.
Cool.
No. I mean, I don't... really hear anything, to be honest with you. I don't know. Who knows?
Okay.
It could all be fucked up. Maybe we just need to get new microphones.
I think it's my headphones.
I do hear, like, a slight, like,
there's a buzzing buzz. Every time somebody talks.
I think it's you. There is a slight buzzing every single time you talk. It's not... No, it's not me. Fuck. It's you.
Fuck. Is my microphone dying mid-episode?
Dude.
Damn it. These mics all die at the same time?
I mean, it makes sense, though.
Yeah. Yeah.
We've been using them a lot, especially recently. Huh?
They're consistent.
I mean, hey, again, I'm going to look up the company that makes them and see if we can just get the microphones for, like, cheap, you know? Like, maybe I can get, like, 4 microphones for $40, you know, instead of getting all of the... Because I'll send them an email and be like, look, we have this whole podcast. We've been using them for fucking 2 years. They work fucking great, like... Tell me how much it is for just the microphones, because they'll last us another 2 years and maybe we spend fucking $40.
Like, yeah.
Come on. You can't fucking beat that. That's great. Could spend like $200 and fucking, you know, get a nice ass microphone, but.
We could spend $2,000 and get 4 sure microphones.
Oh my God. Do you know how fucking great that would be?
We're spending $2,000. We're just not.
I know.
If
yeah.
We're spending $2,000, we're going on a double family vacation.
I don't know if somebody
I'm down for that too.
If somebody donates $2,000 to the podcast, it's going to the podcast.
Oh yeah, if they donate it to the podcast, but if we out of our own pockets
have $2,000, if out of our own pockets, yeah,
to Virginia Beach or
something.
Six Flags.
Heard that. No, I agree. Yeah, no, if we all just individually had, like, $2,000, I would definitely agree with, like, doing that. But if somebody donates $2,000 to our, like. Our Cash App at Blue Skies Pod, or number sign Blue Skies Pod. or our Venmo, you know, which one is that? Is that the at?
Yeah, Venmo's an at, and Cash App is a dollar sign.
A dollar sign, yeah. At Blue Skies Pod, and then isn't there another one? PayPal.
Yeah.
PayPal is also Blue Skies Pod.
Yeah.
So if you guys want to donate $2,000 to us so we can get new microphones, I mean.
Or if you know us in real life, you can write us a check and bring it to our house.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
If you want to do that, any family that's probably not listening or watching.
For sure.
Calling you bitches out.
Fuck, I lost my train of thought again.
It's okay.
This is a bad time for me right now. I'm just blanking.
Do you want to do TikToks and then we can play my game?
Yes, I'm down. Okay. Let's fucking do it, dude. Let me see if I can pull this shit up without fucking it up. Because you know how I be. I don't know if I got all of my TikToks.
I'm just going to order a fucking mic.
Oh, I already put yours in. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, I'm not even going to count them. What's the point?
I can't be micless.
No, you can't. No, sorry.
I'm going to order a mic. It's all right. I might. Where's my phone?
It might just be some way that it's set up. You never know.
Maybe. I'll test it when I get home. I'll wait till I get home.
Wait till you get home, bro. Make sure that it's, you know. Make sure it's that.
I hate that it just started doing it out of nowhere, though.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
I know. It's all right, though. I mean,
all right, let's do these.
First TikTok, here we go.
I know. Momo doesn't go to church. No, Momo is an atheist, 100%. I just need you to go to Sunday school one time for me. I mean, you don't have to listen to anything they say, but it's important. When they ask if anybody needs prayer, I need you to tell them that you need them to pray for your mom because she drinks too much wine. Because your mom did that shit to me the one time I let her go to Sunday school, and I don't let shit go.
That's low-key kind of most of my family. They hold grudges.
Dude.
Take it out on people.
You said what?
This one made me think of you.
This one made you think of me?
Yeah, because you always talk shit on cars.
Oh, always talk shit on cars?
Yeah.
This is my impression of the clapped out Honda that drives by my house at 3 a.m.
This is my impression of the clapped out Honda that drives by my house at 3 o'clock in the fucking morning. Except every time you see me, I'm a little bit more, fun than the last time. I got a small dick. Bow, 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 bow. This next one I like to call the sneaker.
Oh, that's fucking funny. Motherfucker, I hate this keyboard.
I like her whole vibe.
I need a new keyboard. Somebody donate money so I can get a new keyboard. I need a Bluetooth keyboard.
You guys better make an OnlyFans with all these requests.
Oh, yeah, true.
We're just
going
to do a pledge drive.
We're going to do what Garrett was talking about, an Only Dads.
An Only Dads.
An Only Dads. Yeah. That's what we're going to do, dude.
Y'all want to see my toes?
No, dude, we're going to do, like, fireman calendar photos, you know?
Hell yeah.
Oh, you know what I really want to do?
What?
Oh, me and my wife were talking about it.
Dress up like Peaky Blinders?
No. Well, yes. yes, I do want to do that. Yeah. No, but I'm going to pose with the escape in my banana suit.
Oh, okay.
And do, like, a whole photo shoot with the...
Nice. Laying with the, side banana.
With the banana mobile.
Nice.
I need to get a sticker for the back that says that.
Yeah.
Banana mobile.
Fuck, we're making banana mobile merch now.
Fuck yeah, dude. All right. I absolutely love this one, to be honest with you. This is probably one of my favorite TikToks that I've ever seen in my entire life.
It's not even funny. That's the thing. There's a bunch of people. They're on a boat. They all have a bunch of cigarettes, but they don't have anything to light them with. Okay. What do? They take one cigarette, they throw it overboard, and the whole boat becomes a cigarette lighter.
It's the fact that you were the whole...
That's so fucking stupid.
I'm only laughing because you're laughing.
That is so stupid.
I'm befuddled.
Real?
Yeah.
Do you not get it?
No.
They threw the cigarette overboard. Now the whole boat becomes a cigarette lighter.
Kill me now.
That was such a Katie moment. You just pulled a Katie so bad. Oh my God. That's so something she would do. She would sit there like, I don't get it. I want to laugh with you, but I don't.
I'm lost. Help me.
Oh my God.
Fuck, man. I quit the podcast.
Oh God. I'm telling you, I was dying laughing, dude.
Shit, man.
I thought that you would have got that from the get go.
No, I was so focused on it being about, like, the Titanic. I was trying to figure out what boat movie it was. I was like, if this isn't the Titanic, what is he possibly referencing? And that's where my brain was the whole fucking time. I heard the punchline and it didn't even register as a punchline. Like,
he was like, you didn't say Titanic at the end. What the fuck's going on here? I don't get
this joke.
And then
the girl saying, I'm only laughing because you're laughing. I'm like, yeah. That's me right now.
Oh my God. That's hilarious.
God damn. Hey, my mic stopped doing that.
Oh yeah, it did.
Yeah.
Whoa, dude.
I don't know what the fuck.
I don't know either, man. We're just going to roll with it. Fuck it.
I shouldn't have said anything about it.
Nah, you shouldn't have. Okay. So I remember why I had to show this, because when I first watched it, I was expecting there to be like fart sounds over top of the, and then that happens. Like, I lost it. I was losing my shit. Like,
it does kind of feel like that though. Like, when my wife gets out of bed to take a shower, like on the weekend, and it just leaves me in bed under the covers, and I've been holding one in for a while, and I can just fucking let it rip super hard under the covers, and I can waft it up and get a good little whiff of it.
I think guys are weird. We were like, yeah, I want to smell my own farts, dude. I want to know what's going on down there, you know?
I don't wait for you to leave the room. I want you to smell my farts.
Oh, you want me to smell your farts?
Yeah.
Oh, there's certain ones that I give her and certain ones that I save for myself. Okay. Yeah.
Dude, I had to fart so bad last night at this dude's house. Like,
yeah.
I felt so bad. Like, I was holding it in, man, because my farts fucking reek. And I was like, I'm not even trying to do that to him, you know? I'm not even trying to cause those problems, you know? And
you're of the size, too, it's where, like, how does that come out of you? Like, shitty, what are you doing in there?
Shitty diet. Like, really shitty diet.
Yeah. It doesn't make sense.
I remember this one, but I don't remember exactly what's in it, so yeah.
What? Babe, be careful, wear your seatbelt.
Yes, yes.
Not too fast. Love you.
Babe, give me a kiss. They were cute. And he asked for a kiss. And obviously, it's making the relationship way better than ours is, so give me a kiss.
Really?
Dale un beso.
Babe, I'm not fucking playing right now. Babe, be safe. Put the seatbelt on.
Okay. Can you come open the door for me, though?
I gotta open the door for you. What the fuck is that? What's this on?
I want to be a better man, but don't ask too much.
Yeah, he was like, what do you mean I got to open the fucking door for you? What the hell?
Oh, shit.
Oh, man, this one's great. This is great. This video proves, like, the male mentality compared to the female mentality that, you know, like, we're just different. Like, we just think about things differently, and, like, our accomplishments are totally different. Like, guys get so much joy and like, feel accomplished out of the dumbest shit. And this is proof of that.
Yes! Oh!
See, this is why I think sometimes dudes have trouble relating to ladies. Because ladies, I don't really know what you guys like. It seems like you guys like smells, like candles. You like spice racks and organizing them and like leaving makeup around a sink. But guys, we need answers. We need to know what would happen if you tied a rope to the back of your truck and tied the other end of the rope to a wagon and then Frank got in and you drove around real fast. Say that to a group of dudes and they go, yeah. What would happen? That would happen here. These guys were like, what would happen if we kick this ball at the fan? And it turns out the ball goes really far. Pretty sick. Now follow me, you fucking idiots.
First of all, I fucking love this dude. This dude is fucking hilarious. Because follow him.
Yeah, you fucking idiots.
What is it? Cheddarena? Chedurena.
Shout out. We're not going to get your name right, but shout out.
Shout out to you, bro. At the end of all of his videos, he says, follow me, you fucking idiots. Mm-hmm. And, like, somebody was... I forget what it was. It was something like, you know, what would you do if you walked into the room and, like, I was dressed like this? And he was like, okay, scenario. And then just goes on this whole fucking rant. And I was like... Like, the moment that he popped up, I was like, yeah, scenario? Uh-huh. Yeah. And you're getting into that? Uh-huh. And then at the end, it just, like, zooms in on his mouth. And he's like, follow me, you fucking idiots. And I was like, you got me. Nope, I'm going to follow you. And I followed him ever since then. Like,
yeah, no, he definitely sucked you in. I thought the TikTok was over at the end of the dude kicking the ball into the fan. And then when he popped up, I was like, bonus. Hey, I'll watch this.
Yeah. Well, see, this is why I was bringing it up, was because he gave that explanation.
Yeah. No, it was great.
Giving a little bit of context into that. But yeah, I think guys are totally like that, you know?
No, I've done a bunch of real dumb shit just to see if we could do it.
Oh, yeah. Like me taking the wagon down that hill in Sycamore.
Yeah, yeah. The big one.
Yeah.
Over by the fucking...
Tennis courts.
Yeah.
You know they repaved it?
Yeah, we talked about
this. Ah, okay. Yeah, yeah. Man, I missed that thorn bush. That's the most love I've ever gotten on my face.
Yeah.
By a thorn bush.
That thing was all up in you.
Did I ever tell you a story about the
thorn? And you were all up in it.
The thorn bush when I was younger with my brother. My brother was like, I bet you can't jump over this bush. And I was like, I bet you fucking can.
Yeah.
And so I went and tried to jump over the bush. I landed in the middle of the bush. And then I tried to walk out of the bush. But it was a thorn bush. And I didn't feel any pain. I didn't feel anything. I walked out of the bush and was like, la-di-da-di-dee, doo-doo-doo. And we were about to leave. Like, me and my brother were outside waiting on, like, my dad and fucking Suzanne at the time.
Suzanne.
Fuck her. First of all, fuck Suzanne. Huh?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, you never met her, no. Thankfully.
Sorry to everybody listening named Suzanne, but...
So my dad...
That Suzanne.
Yeah. So my dad walks out, and he's like, what the fuck happened? And I'm like... What do you mean? And I look down, and my legs are bloody as shit. Dude, there's just a bunch of blood like running down because I ran through a thorn bush, basically. And, yeah, my dad was not happy because we were late to something because I was bleeding everywhere.
Damn.
Yeah.
No, dudes will do shit like that even unprompted. Like, I have been poked in the ass by a tall traffic cone down at Kansas, also at Sycamore. Because there was a tall traffic cone down there, and it was down by the little creek area that was under the bridge, and we were jumping over it. And I was like, well, actually, I think I was the one who prompted
unprompted
people to jump over it, because I tried it first and just pogoed my ass off the top of it, because I missed it by just a tiny bit. Yeah.
Other people should have this experience.
Yeah.
So you credit carded this traffic cone up your ass.
Yeah, I totally swiped it right in there. And then it declined the payment.
It declined the payment, too?
Yeah.
Yeah. That's a bad day,
I was left hurting.
That's a bad day.
Yeah.
Holy shit, your bank's calling you? Like, you know that you don't have any money in here, right?
Like, hold on, I'm on the phone with the doctor. The proctologist.
You're telling me I need a colonoscopy now. Okay.
Hey, but at least it's got a flared base.
Yeah.
So, you know, it was not a bad choice.
If I hadn't been wearing pants, I do like to imagine that I would have just swirled down onto it.
Like the reverse South Park when he shits out the largest turd, you know? But just play that whole scene in reverse.
Just Yeah.
That's fucking gross, dude. That's fucking gross, man.
They said there was a traffic jam, but...
Yeah, that's fucking funny.
Being in an open relationship is great because now I'm like rejection proof, you know? Like I could go to a guy's house and he could be like, ooh, you're ugly. And I can just be like, you're not my real boyfriend.
Yeah. Yeah. Real talk. Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. 100%.
True facts.
I don't know, but even like being in a marriage now, like I'm just like, I don't give a shit. Like somebody could say whatever they want about me. I'm like, I already got a wife and a kid at home. So like,
I can get as ugly as I want.
Yeah, basically. Like I don't. Or, I mean,
I would say I don't get offended, but I got offended this episode. So I'll just I'll let you guys.
You got offended this episode by something that I said?
No, I wouldn't get offended by somebody saying that I'm ugly because I have a wife and kids.
But yeah.
Sexy Saint said you're the cuter of the two of us.
Oh, so. And you got offended?
Yeah, a little bit.
Oh, man, I'm sorry.
For a split second, I was like, hey.
Oh.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, well, that hey, makes sense.
You know what? You know what? That's probably the reason.
Yeah.
That's probably the reason. Let's be real here.
Got them drunk goggles on.
Yeah. I mean, I'm not saying I'm not, like, cute or whatever, but, like, damn, Wes is fucking...
Yeah, when I first met Austin, I was drunk. I was 14, but I was drunk.
I feel so much better now.
Yeah. So, next TikTok, now that my whole fucking life has been sent and,
Send it?
Yeah. Fuck me, right?
No, we love you.
I'm gonna buy some Christmas.
What's funny is I'm holding in coughing right now because I drank that beer, like, a little too quick, but...
Better not. You'll get a TikTok.
I know. Don't make TikToks about me.
Oh, I will make TikToks
about
you.
Don't make TikToks
about me. I'm going to make a TikTok about you now.
That's in the contract of our friendship, is that you're not allowed to make TikToks about me.
That's fucked up. There's no fucking way.
You signed it.
First of all, when did I sign the contract?
You drank a lot.
When did I sign the contract?
I'm bad.
You're
the better improviser of the two. I could have said any date. I could have said any date.
Anything. And you know what I would have told you? It was before TikTok. TikTok wasn't even around. Because that would have been okay, but we've known each other well before
then. I just got you drunk one night and you signed a contract.
That is not totally improbable.
Okay? That's my point.
Like, that could that
maybe
definitely
I don't remember
happened.
The day that it happened. Because I also drank a lot.
I didn't sign your fucking contract, though. I know that for a fact.
I don't remember if you did or didn't.
I didn't.
I know for a fact
so now
I didn't.
Now it's just a mystery.
I haven't signed any contracts.
Pretty sure you did.
Nah. Nah, sure I've never signed a contract a day in my life, dude.
I mean, I watched you do it.
Nah.
Yeah.
Nah. Nope. No contracts here, dude. I'm a contract-free man, okay?
Are you both looking behind me for... I'm worried that you wouldn't tell me if there was something happening behind me.
Just a dude with a machete behind you. Me and her just looking at him and looking back at each other. Like, should we tell him?
I saw you both look, and I'm like,
no. Just the lights from a car across the street. But I think it both caught our eye at the same time.
When I was a child and I wanted something from my mom, I would wait till she was drunk, and then I would have her sign a contract. Like, that's how I was allowed to see the movie The Hangover. Because I waited till she got drunk.
Son of a bitch.
And I said, hey, can I watch The Hangover? And she said, sure. And I said, okay, but sign this contract. So tomorrow when you're sober and you don't remember. And she did. And I got to watch it. So, yeah.
Damn it. I wish I'd thought of that. Mm-hmm. Yeah, because my mom was often zooted. And I could have taken so much advantage. I was not as clever as you growing up. I would just sneak out and do dumb shit and get caught.
I was going to say, like, if I would have thought of that shit, you know,
yeah.
All the times that my mom was, like, fucked up and been like, hey, sign this contract real quick, like, proving that I'm allowed to, you know, go smoke weed or something like that.
Yeah.
And then every time she brought it up, be like, you signed the contract. I can go smoke weed.
No, I'm so glad that you didn't, because your mom already makes very clear that you were a lot to deal with.
Oh, well, so, yeah, but I mean...
If you were manipulative like me and all the other stuff...
Yeah, I think, Yeah, I still have to have that conversation with my mom where I'm like, you say that I was difficult, but like that was somewhat you're doing too.
Yeah.
Like
we don't even need to talk about it.
You started that shit. Is all I'm saying. She started it, okay? I don't want to point fingers or anything, but like she started it. Anyways, next TikTok though.
Let's do this.
We can go ahead and get it. I hate that I have to like lift my keyboard up to switch shit. It's annoying.
If this is you, you better lower your motherfucking tone when you're talking to me.
I tell you what, you're not gonna.
I love that he committed real hard to the bit and also has a small penis. Small penis.
Like, oh my god, dude. Oh, fuck. Oh, I love TikTok, dude, sometimes. Oh, my God. See, this one's fucking great, too. Like, oh, man. I had some great TikToks this time, guys. I'm sorry. I don't want to toot my own horn, but toot toot.
When I'm peeing in a toilet, I don't pee directly into the water. I pee on the curved part of the bowl beside the water because I figure it splashes less. But when you're peeing that close to the edge, the sporadic tiny offshoots of pee become a greater threat. I'm not sure if the accumulation of these offshoots is greater than the potential splashback from peeing mid-bowl. It's possible that I'm thinking about this too much, but it's also possible that I'm not thinking about this enough. It's possible.
I'm in love, for one. I pee on the cornered backside edge of the left side of the bowl right above the water to reduce noise.
Yeah.
And I pick that spot to also make sure that most of the splash is staying inside of the bowl. And it's as close to the water as I can so that, like, if it is running off, it's in the spot that I clean. So, like, when he said that, I identified hard with the...
Dude, I just fucking piss into the middle of it. Like,
I'm a nervous person, and the sound makes me upset.
We talked about it before, and I just, it's whatever.
Yeah.
Either or, you know, if you try and like silence it, there is gonna be those splashes that go off, and you're still gonna have to clean the side of the toilet. Or I can just fucking pee into the middle of the fucking water, and it's gonna splash out anyways.
Yeah.
So fuck it, whatever.
Catch it.
Catch it in my hand? You want me to catch my pee?
And then
listen, if you told me to catch my poop, I might go along with it. Like, I might. I'm not gonna lie. Like, if you, because you're a good arguer, okay? Like, you are, and, like, that's why I get pissed the fuck off at you sometimes, too, because, like, you know how to keep it fucking going and just keep, like, fucking going on with shit, and that, like, that's what pisses me off. So I know that if you were to tell me to catch my poop, that you would have enough to be able to convince me to catch my poop. But catching my pee, though, I'd be like, nah. You got me sitting down, though. You got me sitting down.
That's true.
I will sit down sometimes. That's fair enough. Fair enough on that one. I hope the sound was on for that. I don't know if it was.
Funky Mountain Dew can.
Right. Yeah, it's just Mountain Dew. What do you mean? You ready for the next one?
No.
Okay. I'll wait till you're ready.
I've been singing Frozen songs with sexually explicit lyrics.
Oh, really?
Yeah, that's been stuck in my head. I don't remember the name of the song, but there's one where I've just been singing, my cock is small, my dick is hard. Or variations of that, where I'm like, my ass is clean. It's always my dick is small, and then some other thing.
Listen, if this is you, you need to lower your motherfucking tone when you talk to me.
I'm sorry, I was talking way too loud.
When we were on our way to the girls' trip, Katie was driving, and she saw, like, we passed, like, a pumpkin patch, and they have, like,
like cardboard cutout characters on the side or whatever. And one was the snowman from Frozen. And I didn't see him at the time, the cutout. But Katie was like, oh, it's the snowman from Frozen. It's Zoloft.
Zoloft?
I was like, you mean Olaf? She's like, I knew it was something like that.
Maybe you should come sit next to me.
Either way, it puts you to sleep.
Yeah. Maybe you should come sit next to me, because then I can just kind of like move the microphone over. Because I can scooch over a little bit, and then you can just like sit next to me. I mean, I would like it for the simple fact that it'd be easier to be able to hear you when you decide to talk.
You like to hear me?
I do like to hear. I know that our audience also likes to hear you. So
that's why I've been giving you the mic, too. Like,
aww, I like this.
Yeah, this isn't bad.
Yeah, this is cool.
Oh, shit. Sorry, neighbors.
hold on, Wes. I'm going to do something, actually.
Okay.
I'm going to...
You keep talking. I'm going to go pee.
All right, yeah. Hi, babe.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm all right.
You're all right?
Yeah.
That's good.
I'm tired. I'm going to go to bed.
You tired?
Yeah.
You want to go to bed? I want to take a nap. I want to take a nap right here. Mm-hmm. Well, after our TikToks, you can go if you want. Yeah. All right, we'll speed through these. We'll get through these. When are we going to get, like, an 8-channel audio interface?
I know. Like, we definitely. I've been looking at a few.
Have you really?
Yeah.
That's what's up. I'm just gonna put this in my lap now.
Because we can plug more shit in, like.
Oh yeah, for sure. Yeah.
That's why I like my mixer.
Tumble out of bed and I ow.
I tumble out of bed.
I'm sad that you didn't hear that. Oh, you did? Okay. I just thought it was funny because it was like, tumble out of bed and ow.
Ow.
And I was like, I fucking feel that shit. I was like,
that song's great, too.
That, I
got excited when it came on.
I feel it. I feel it.
Crystal's a huge Dolly fan.
Oh, yeah?
So I hear it a lot. I'm in love with that song. And the slowed down version of Jolene is amazing.
Huh.
Miley Cyrus's cover of Jolene.
Also amazing.
Yeah.
But she was like an understudy to Dolly.
All right. Next TikTok?
Yeah.
I might just see.
See if I can turn the gain up a little bit. And then way, you know, I can still be back here.
Yeah. I can hear you the same amount.
Yeah.
Dick made a sound every time it got hard. What would you want that sound to be?
I'm going to stop it right here.
Okay, so we've seen this setup before, and also we've done this setup before. It seems to be a popular thing online. I would like to claim that we did it first, and we started the trend.
I would like to also say that we were definitely the ones who started this whole trend.
Yeah, I've never heard anybody else say it before we did. It became a thing after.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, it definitely became a thing after. I remember her actually like laying in bed next, because that was when we started doing the podcast, when that episode came out.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, actually. Yeah, that's true.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I guess I'll play the rest of it.
Oh, yeah. What's the rest of the TikTok?
Oh, I didn't turn the fucking sound on. Here, I'll just play the
whole thing. Dick made a sound every time it got hard. What would you want that sound to be?
He was like, sorry.
That's not a bad choice.
No, not at all.
Yeah.
Oh, this one I totally approve of.
Okay.
And I even like commented on the post and was like, I approve of this. So.
Well, we need your approval.
Yeah. No. Well, especially this guy. And you'll get why.
Okay.
You'll understand why.
I'm sure I will.
Hello, everybody. I looked at how to make a no melody song, and I think I kind of got it. Bananas, bananas everywhere. Put them all inside my hair. Potassium, potassium. Give me all of that potassium.
I like the looking around.
Hey, how you doing? I'm your best friend. I'm gonna see it to the end. Give you the Hemi, the Chevy. Wanna go VA? I ain't an enemy, but I can be one if you really want it. I can show a love to your house if you want it.
I mean, I'm down with it. Yeah, I'm down with it. Fuck it.
I liked it. It was cool. We need more banana songs.
We do need more banana songs.
Always more banana songs. I don't know if you heard her. She said she'll be back.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, I saw.
Yeah.
No, but I did not hear her say that she would be back. So that's good to know, actually.
Oh, look how white my arms are. Oh.
Yeah, look at you, sexy motherfucker, with your white ass arms.
Yeah.
Was talking to somebody and was like, I think it was that dude I was hanging out with last night.
Yeah, the dude.
Yeah. We got on like the whole like Black Lives Matter thing, and I was like, you know, I'm not there to stand up for you, I'm just there to stand up beside you type shit, you know, like that's how you got to think about it. Yeah. You know, like they don't need our help, they just need us to stand beside them, you know. Yeah. To know that they like that we support them, you know, and this shit, like, remember that.
Yeah.
just take that in, people out there.
We've had that conversation before, where like when you're part of the problem, it doesn't feel good for the oppressor to be the helping hand.
No.
Like, it's that Nine Inch Nails song, dude.
Yeah.
The hand that feeds.
You ready next TikTok?
Yeah.
Let's fucking do it.
So I just got my second COVID dose. I'm just in the recovery area. Everything was great. Everyone was lovely. On my way here, though, I did see a couple of anti-vaxxers with signs that were like, you know, the vaccines made with dead fetuses, aborted fetuses. And this one woman was like, they're going to shoot dead babies up your arm. Do you want that? Honey, before the pandemic, I would let men shoot dead babies up my ass. So, yeah.
I like that. You're looking at me like,
take me back to the glory days.
As he's saying this,
I feel great. So, if anyone wants to come in my
wait, I was trying to switch it before.
I feel great. If anyone, yeah.
Oh my god, fantastic. Oh jeez.
You at the end of that fucking TikTok.
Yeah. Yeah, for sure.
Sorry, Twitch. This we know you're owned by Amazon.
This one was actually for my wife, but she had to go and take a break. So, yeah, I'm sure you'll agree with this one, though.
I'm sure.
Oh, I shut him up real quick, dude.
Oh, I'm totally fine.
Yeah. Squirt whipped cream into anybody's mouth at any point in time, and they'll be like, all right, whatever. You know, I'm good. I'm good now.
If anybody is open mouth wailing, just fucking squirt some fucking whipped cream in there. They'll be good.
I just want to walk up to like two buff dudes in the middle of a bar, you know, and just fucking squirt whipped cream into their mouths and see what the fuck happens, you know? I'm gonna get my ass beat for sure, but it'll be hilarious in the moment.
I was on a keto diet.
I got one of two options here. Either they're gonna find it hilarious, or they're gonna be like, what the fuck are you doing, and then beat the shit out of me. So like, I got a 50-50 chance here.
Was that sugar free?
that was the end of our TikTok.
Oh, that was the end of the TikTok.
That was the end of the TikTok.
Cool.
Apollo City's back now.
Oh, those dishes took forever, bruh.
Those dishes did take forever. That was our whole, like, TikTok section, and you just now got back.
Mm-hmm.
So, what's up, Wes? How was your past couple weeks, man? Anything exciting happened to you? Did you slightly inconvenience anybody? My escape doesn't get up to speed real quick, and when I'm getting onto like on ramps or something like that, people will ride my ass, and I will intentionally go slower than what I actually really could just to piss them off even more.
Yeah.
So like, I mean, have you done that to anybody or anything like that? You know?
Oh yeah. I've done that. I do that a bunch too. Where like my car is a base model of a Chevy Spark. It's a tiny little fucking car.
Yeah.
It does. I mean, it can zoom when it wants to, but it's hard on the engine. So I go I go the speed that I want to go when I'm fucking getting up to speed on ramps, and I can only go so fast. And I get fucking I'm furious at like semis not knowing the like if you're going 65 and I see you coming up behind me as I'm getting onto the highway. Do not fucking slow down.
No.
You're a semi, and I'm trying to gauge your speed as I'm coming on.
No, just keep your speed, and because you're supposed to yield.
Yeah, exactly.
Technically, like,
I've had so many semis like slow down, and like in this week where like they'll slow down as I'm coming in. And I'm like, what now? Okay, so now I gotta gun it to get ahead of you.
Yeah,
you gave
no.
me the space.
No,
I appreciate you being nice, but fuck you.
Yeah. Yeah, no, really, you're just harming both of us.
Because
now I gotta speed up, and then it's gonna take you, the semi, like, even much more power for you to get back up to speed. Like, no, you were supposed to keep your speed as somebody that's already on the freeway. Somebody that's getting on the freeway is supposed to yield to you and to judge your speed, and then slow down or speed up accordingly.
Yeah, sometimes you gotta gun it if people are being dicks, or sometimes
which is like 90% of the time.
Exactly,
you know, like 90% of the time people are just being fucking dicks, and you're just like, I gotta fucking deal with it.
Why are you being an asshole in the fucking off lane?
I don't understand, dude. Yeah. I really fucking don't. I was talking with somebody about this recently, where I was like, I don't understand why people don't take driving so seriously. And they're just so careless. And it might have been me with, like, growing up with, like, drag racing. And that was, like, something serious. Where it was, like, if you fuck up, like, you're putting your life in danger.
Yeah.
And so, like, that's how I look at driving, you know? It's, like, I'm putting my life in danger. But also now, other people's lives. And even, like, with drag racing, there's somebody next to you, too. So, like, if I do something wrong, and then all of a sudden I veer off into the right-hand lane, and I'm in the left lane, and I slam into somebody else, I could injure somebody else.
You're fucking with somebody else's life.
Yeah, so you gotta take it serious. So that's how I felt, like, my entire life. Is like, you know, you gotta know that this is something serious. And that was with junior dragsters.
Yeah.
I mean, now we're talking about, like, close to a ton weight in cars.
Yeah.
And you're doing 65 down the fucking freeway, sometimes fucking 85. If you were to slam into somebody, like, on their driver's side door or whatever, like, you can fucking kill somebody. Like,
yeah.
Grant, I will be honest, because of airbags and stuff and airbag technology, and even you listen to Elon Musk?
Yeah.
That episode where he was like, seatbelts are fucking obsolete, basically, now, with, like, newer cars, because airbag technology has become so advanced where it's like, even if, you know, the car flips over or whatever, like, you're just gonna be on this cloud, basically, of like airbags, like you'll be all right.
That's I've been saying that shit for years.
So,
finally, somebody way smarter than me verified what I've already been saying, and I'm like, all right,
yeah. What's up?
What's up?
Anxiety. I'm fine.
Oh, okay. I'm glad you're all right. What were we talking about?
Cars,
and serious, yeah. So anytime that somebody's, like, speeding up on me or being a dick, I'm just like, fuck it, whatever. I'm just gonna be a dick back to you, honestly. Like, whatever.
Yeah.
Sort of shit. So,
I has game.
You has game?
I has game.
You has game?
Would you like to play a game?
Give me game.
Give game.
Give game.
I will give game.
Give game.
Guys, game. In chat, if you're still here, if anybody's here, you can play along, too.
Oh yeah, please play along. Yeah. Maybe I'll look at chat for the answers.
Don't do that.
I'm gonna cheat off of chat. Chat, I need you to Google these things.
It's
Google pulled up already, okay?
Yes,
Google pulled up already. That way when we play this game, you can just tell me what the answers are so I can win. Because I'm not good at winning these games.
Why are you sabotaging the game before I even start the game?
I'm just having fun, man.
The game.
The game. So what's the game called, bud?
The game could be called several different things. It could go by many names, but it's typically, this is a classic game that a dead podcast used to do that I love, but it's also a thing that a lot of people have done before.
Cumtown? You talking about Cumtown?
Cumtown's still going.
Oh, or,
Mean Boys.
Mean Boys.
Yeah.
That was the other one.
Bad. So the game is, which of the following?
Which of the following?
One of these is false, or one of these is true, that type of thing. So this is which of the following, and basically for this version of the game, I'm going to do which of the following is false. So I'm going to give you four options, one of them is going to be not real.
So four options, one of them, so three of them are real, one of them's not.
Yes.
Okay.
Three real, one fake.
Okay, so this is like two truths and a lie.
Yeah, kind of like that.
But now it's three truths and a lie.
Yeah, All right. There's an extra one in there to throw you guys off a little
bit. Yeah. All right.
Round one. One of these is false.
Okay.
All right. You can't breathe and swallow at the same time. If you folded a piece of paper 42 times, it would reach the moon. Hair and fingernails continue to grow after death. Saudi Arabia imports camels from Australia.
Okay, hold on. Whoa. No, we'll go back there. If you folded a piece of paper 48 times, you would reach the moon?
I'm prepared for this, yeah.
If you fold...
That one is not true.
What?
That one is absolutely true.
If you folded a piece of paper 48 times, you would...
42 times.
42 times.
The magic number. The answer to life, the universe, and
everything.
That's
crazy. you would reach the moon?
Yeah.
In what sense?
It would... When you fold a piece of paper in half, a paper is the width that it is, and then you fold it in half, you've now doubled its width. When you fold it in half again, you've now quadrupled its width. When you fold it in half again, you've now eight times its width. And that keeps going exponentially. So if you can't physically fold a piece of paper more than like eight times or something like that, there becomes a point where it's too dense to fold. But if you were physically able to continue folding that piece of paper, it would be so thick... because of the exponential rate of growth at a certain point that it would reach the moon. It would be tall enough to make it to the moon.
No fucking way.
Yes. That one is absolutely true.
I'm calling bullshit, dude.
That you can Google that. And there's YouTube videos.
I'm calling fucking bullshit.
This is a classic thought experiment, and you can watch videos on YouTube about it where it is absolutely, scientists will tell you it's true.
I'm calling fucking bullshit.
It's absolutely true. I'm
calling so much bullshit,
so
dude.
The first one, the one that you can't breathe and hold your breath at the same time?
Yeah.
Is that the false one?
Try and do it. I'm so prepared for all of these.
Wait, you mean try and breathe and swallow at the same time?
I can't do it. I'm thinking like...
I would say most people can't do this.
Okay, because I was thinking like ventriloquists, right?
Oh, yeah, there are people who can also do, like, throat singing and weird shit like that.
Okay, so that's not the... Wait, what were the other two? Because after the fucking folding it 42... Folding the piece of paper 42 times to reach the moon, I was like, that's gotta be it.
So the first two are absolutely true.
Oh, okay, so now we got a 50-50 here.
Yeah.
I'm still gonna guess the fucking wrong
one. I'm hoping not.
Hair and fingernails continue to grow after death, and Saudi Arabia imports camels from Australia.
So it's the last one fake.
That one's also absolutely true.
I was going to say that your hair and nails don't grow after you die.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think that I, like, kind of already knew that, but I can't know the... Because...
It's one of those old wives' tales.
Your nails are dead cells, aren't they?
Yeah. It's just keratin being pushed out.
Yeah.
And it grows from the nail bed. And same with your hair. It grows from the pore. So... It's just an old wives' tale. Nerve cells die minutes after death, so all that stuff stops growing. And that originated because what's actually happening is the skin on bodies when they die starts to recede, so it just looks like the nails got longer.
Okay.
Yep. Same with the hair on the skin on the scalp. Like, it recedes a bit and the hair gets pushed out.
Yeah.
Yep.
Okay. That makes sense.
The first one was tough.
It was a little tough. Not gonna lie.
All right. All right, round two. The Earth orbits the sun. Hippo milk is pink. I love this.
I know the first one.
Woody's full name from Toy Story is Woody Pride.
I don't know that one, actually.
Lion King came out closer to the moon landing than it did to today.
That's true.
Yes.
That's true. I know for a fact that that one's true.
Yes.
For sure. Because Lion King... 1969, right? In the
summer of 1969? Something like that, yeah.
It happened the same year as Woodstock, so because that happened in This Is Us recently.
Yeah.
Oh, fuck.
And Lion King's one of...
You said Lion King came out in 1969.
No, the moon landing.
Oh.
69.
And
Lion King probably came out in like...
1991 or 92. Where's my fucking phone at?
Siri?
Yeah.
When did The Lion King come out?
Yeah, tell me that shit. Please.
No, stop talking.
Oh, my bad.
Hey, Siri. When did The Lion King come out?
94.
94? In the middle. Yeah. We're both close.
It's kind of in the middle, but we know that the last one's true.
Yep.
Okay, so go over them again real quick for me one more time.
Okay. The Earth orbits the sun. Hippo Milk is pink, and Woody's full name from Toy Story is Woody Pride.
I think it's the hippo's milk is pink. That's the wrong one.
I'll let you guess.
It's one. It's either the second one or the third one.
Okay, so you're going with Hippo Milk is pink, yes. And you're going with Woody's full name is Woody Pride.
Yes.
Those are both true. Hippo Milk is pink. It's bright pink, actually.
Okay, so you're being more specific where, like, the Earth doesn't revolve around the sun, where it's more like it spirals around the sun. Like, the sun is, traveling through space also, so it's not that necessarily the Earth is revolving around the sun, but it's just, like, pulled in by its gravitational pull.
Exactly, so...
Yeah, oh, so I should have... Look, I just explained it. Yeah. I knew the answer to it and still did not get it right.
So, number one, the Earth orbits the sun, that's the false one.
Obviously you're not.
The Earth, the Sun, and all the planets actually orbit the center mass of the solar system, which, while close to the Sun because of its net mass, isn't the center. So it kind of wobbles around the Sun.
I'm so mad at myself right now. So Hippo Milk is fucking pink, dude?
Hippo Milk is bright pink.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
Is that what we would call strawberry milk? Is that where it comes from? Is that why brown cows create chocolate milk, right? Yeah?
I take it back.
Wasn't it something like 86% of the population believes that brown cows make chocolate milk?
Why would it taste like chocolate? What the fuck? Just because they're... That's cowcist.
Oh, I want a cow tattoo.
That's bovinist.
Oh, God, that's fucking funny, dude. That's fucking hilarious. I'm sorry, but that's fucking funny.
All right. Round three.
Yeah, round three. So, what's the score here, though?
0-0.
Oh, yeah, yeah, neither of us got either of them. Yeah. Yeah. Good point.
All right. Good. Number one, the nursery rhyme Humpty Dumpty never once says that he's an egg.
Humpty Dumpty sat on the wall. Humpty Dumpty had a great fall. All the king's horses and all the king's men couldn't put Humpty Dumpty back together again. At no point does it say that Humpty Dumpty is an egg.
I mean, there's more to the nursery rhyme as well.
Well, yes, but I also know that the answer to that, and that is true.
Okay, all right. You're calling them as they come.
Yeah, I know that one's true.
France still executed people by guillotine when Star Wars was released.
They didn't stop doing that until, I want to say it was like 1986 or something like that.
You're on.
That's
pretty fucking close.
I think that's pretty close.
Star Wars came out in 1977.
Yeah. Yes, it was after Star Wars came out for sure. So I know that one's true too.
You guys are doing good.
What do you mean you guys? I just answered both of those, bro.
You didn't have to give it away to me.
You're helping her.
I mean, true. I don't know. We're working together on this, okay? We're working together.
All right. It's a team game now.
I wanted to just prove Wes that we're smart.
Oh, we are basically doing the idea that we had where it's, are you smarter than a me? All right. The unicorn is the national animal of Scotland. Police require a waiting period of at least 24 hours to file a missing persons report.
The third one is false,
yeah.
You both will be shocked to learn that you're wrong again.
Wait,
on three rounds now.
I'm
I'm not shocked anymore.
Wait, the fourth one's wrong? No, I thought that it was a 24-hour rule.
So the unicorn is actually the national animal of Scotland, and you can read some pretty fucking hilarious articles about how people are mad about the Minister of Scotland. She's a female, and she will not admit that unicorns are not real. It's awesome. So that's absolutely true.
Can you hand me that bottle?
Police here? Requiring okay. a waiting period of at least 24 hours to file missing persons report.
Yeah.
That's false, and it's just convenient cop drama Hollywood nonsense useful for plot. That's absolutely really? Not true. If you believe somebody is missing, you are always free to file a report.
No shit.
That does not mean they will investigate, but you can file a report whenever.
Oh, man. I'm so mad.
Now you know, and you don't need to wait 24 hours.
Whenever you go missing, heard that. Yeah, because the moment that you go missing, I'm definitely calling the police immediately.
He's only 72 hours.
I mean, that's the shit that people believe, though, is like when you look it up, because I looked this up, too. I was like, no, because I found a list of like facts that are true or false that you commonly hear. And it was like a long-ass list. And I went through all of them and I found the ones that I liked. And I Googled a lot of them because I was like, well, okay, give me proof then. But yeah, it's just Hollywood nonsense. That
Can I
a
hit
lot of
somebody's
people...
vape? Would that be okay? I have mine, but mine's just so loud, I just don't feel like... causing an issue with the audio.
I don't know if you'll like this, but it's 5%, so it's gonna hit.
We're
rough.
Vaccinated, right?
Yeah. Well, I'm half vaccinated.
You're half vaccinated?
Yeah. It's next weekend.
I'm also half vaccinated. That sucks, dude. All right. Well, I'm fucking.
You'll probably like
too,
that better.
So
than...
it's less than an issue. Mine's... If I was gonna get COVID from you, I would get it from you anyways because we fucking live together.
And I read that after you get your first shot, like a few days after, you're already like. 60% or 80%.
Yeah, the second one's so, more of a booster shot. Yeah.
So then it goes up to like 90-something, which is cool. I'm still gonna get my second one, but
yeah. All right, so we're gonna.
So we're still 0-0.
Yeah.
We're doing terrible on this, babe.
No, we're not. We're tied.
No, but I mean, like, just trying to get him right. We're doing terrible.
I did.
I didn't say like, oh, I'm doing terrible. Or you, I'm saying we as a group, we're doing terrible. Yeah, we haven't gotten any of them fucking right. We're doing terrible.
I wasn't sure if this was going to be easy or hard. Like, I just compiled
it's
a list.
It's good,
of,
though,
yeah.
Because it's like, it's sometimes common it's misconceptions is what it feels like.
Yeah, a little bit. All right. So this is round 4. And this is all real or all fake. This is kind of like...
All right, I'll let you read them all off first before I decide to okay. call them out. Because if I know that one's real, then I know that all of them are real.
Okay.
Or if I know that one's fake, I'll know that all of them are fucking fake.
Well, know that I picked some weird yeah. ones for this.
Well, obviously, I know you're not going to fucking make it easy on us yeah. either, you know? All right, hit us with the...
All right, number one. The there are more fake flamingos in the world than real ones. Number two. The name Jessica was invented by Shakespeare. Number 3. There are fewer atoms on Earth than ways to shuffle a deck of cards. I threw that one in for me because I love cards. Number 4. Oxford University is older than the Aztec Empire.
Okay, so hold on. Let's go back to... The shuffling of a deck of cards.
Yeah.
Just give me the answer of how many ways there are to shuffle a deck of cards.
You're lucky I have this in here.
I knew that you fucking would. Why do you think I even asked you it?
So it would be 8 times 10 to this...
56?
67th.
67th?
Yeah, and there's a good reason for that, but I don't remember what it is. 8 times 10 to the 67th ways to sort a deck of cards.
Okay.
That's 8... The number 8, uh-huh. followed by 67 zeros.
Okay.
Yeah.
And then there are more atoms in the world.
There are fewer atoms on Earth than ways to shuffle a deck of cards.
There are fewer atoms?
Yeah, atoms.
So atoms is what makes up like...
It's like a base particle, yeah.
Everything.
Yeah.
Is the beginning of everything. So like you in yourself...
I'm made up of a bunch of atoms.
Have... Probably.
I've got Adam inside me.
More atoms in yourself.
Was that Blink 182 song about a guy or about
atoms? You and yourself probably have more atoms than there are ways to shuffle a deck of cards.
Yeah. I don't know. Do you believe that?
I believe that it's close. just with one person, I believe that is close. Yeah. So I'm going to say that that's false. So I'm going to go, I'm going to go with false.
You're going to go all true?
Yeah.
All false.
I'm going all false.
I'm going to read them off one more time.
Please do.
There are more fake flamingos in the world than real ones.
You know what? That seems fucking real, though. Seriously? All the people that put fucking fake flamingos in their fucking yard, dude. Like, that was the... When you read that off, I was like, fuck, it's all true. It's all true. I was like, oh, every single one of these are true. I might change my mind, honestly.
Are flamingos, like, on the list of extinct species? Like, I have...
Yes.
Are they?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Hold on.
Well, not extinct.
No. Yeah. They're on the endangered species...
Oh, this motherfucker's gonna Google it.
Are flamingos on the endangered species list?
Okay, I found this on the web for a flamingos on the endangered species list. Check it out.
Flamingos endangered, facts and blah, 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 blah.
Facts
right
and
now,
blah, blah, blah.
None of the species of flamingos are considered to be endangered. Yet many research find that what takes place in our environment now could reduce their numbers significantly in the not so distant future.
So they're fine right now.
Oh, they are fine right now, but man, I don't know. There's all these people out here who like fucking flamingos.
People like fucking flamingos.
Yeah, dude. Yeah. Listen, I've been on some fucked up sides. I've been on some fucked up sides of the internet, all right? There's some crazy people out there, okay? Crazy people out there. All right, I've seen some fucked up videos. Wes was the one that sent me the video of somebody fucking a flamingo, man. Like, he's the one that sends me that shit. I mean, allegedly. Allegedly.
Okay, I want to know.
You want to know? Oh, okay. All right, you know what? Is this the last round?
Yeah, this is the last round.
Yeah.
I have some bonus facts at the end, but...
Okay, so I'm going to go... I said false, right?
Yeah.
Okay, and you said true, so let's just fucking stand by it.
Okay.
Give us the answer.
Well, I was going to read through them all.
Yeah, yeah, go ahead.
More fake flamingos in the world than real ones. The name Jessica was invented by Shakespeare. There are fewer atoms on Earth than ways to shuffle a deck of cards.
Yep.
Spelled A-T-O-M-S. That's not a trick question.
Yeah.
Oxford University is older than the Aztec Empire.
I'm right.
Yeah.
I feel confident.
Yeah, you're right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. See, I was already like, feeling like there was less flamingos in the world.
Do you want to know how many atoms are on Earth?
I do, actually. How many atoms are on Earth?
Okay, so the number of ways to shuffle a deck of cards was 8, followed by 67
zeros. 67
zeros,
yeah.
So the Earth is 1.33 times 10 to the 50th, so it's 1 and a little bit more, and then followed by 50 zeros.
Oh, okay. Now, is that just the Earth?
That's just the Earth. How many atoms are in the...
The Earth, not including us.
On Earth. How many atoms are on Earth?
So you're not including, like, the inside of Earth?
No, just all of Earth.
All of Earth, yeah. Including us and everything that we do.
The other crazy thing, though, is that there's more stars than there are grains in the beaches.
Yeah.
Yeah. Of the entire planet. So it's a similar thing where, like...
Okay.
The number of ways to shuffle a deck and permutations and combinations are just almost infinite, basically.
So you said... How many cards are in it?
52.
52. Did you say 67?
There's reasons for that I do not have written down that I'm not going to be able to remember right now.
Oh, okay.
But I did look this one up.
Okay.
Yeah. On both ends of it, too.
Huh?
GTS.
GTS? What the fuck does that mean?
Google that shit.
Google that shit. If I really want to know, I'll Google that shit.
That's what my mom tells me.
Yeah, I say the same fucking thing, though. Like, when somebody's like, hey, man, how much does a whale weigh? How much does an average whale weigh? And I'm like, why are you fucking asking me? Like, yes, I could potentially know this information, and I appreciate you coming to me because you think that I might know this information, but, like, why didn't you just fucking Google that shit?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Text Cha-Cha.
Text Cha-Cha. That's some old shit. Yeah, that is a show your age shit, though. Real talk. You want to go to the zoo? Yeah, I'd like to go to the zoo, too. Can we take, like, mushrooms or something and go?
No, we're to take our kid.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, we can microdose.
Yeah.
Well, I've never done mushrooms before. I don't want to be the first time at the zoo with our kid.
Really?
Yeah.
You don't think so?
I like to get real high when I go to the zoo. I just get burnt.
Do you go with your kids, though?
Yeah.
Yeah.
But not take mushrooms.
I would do edibles, but I don't know about mushrooms.
I think that we could microdose some fucking mushrooms and go.
Oh, microdosing you'd be fine.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, if we microdose and take some mushrooms and go to the fucking zoo, dude, you would have a fucking blast. Obviously, you'd be like, are these fucking polar bears? Holy shit!
We would not do drugs around our child. Obviously not.
Yeah. Yeah.
For legal purposes, we're just kidding.
Yeah, I see what you're saying, though.
I mean, you don't even do things anyway.
I don't, actually. I really don't.
Beer at the zoo. They do sell beer at the zoo.
They do. And it makes me want to get a $7 beer every time. Oh. Yeah.
Yeah, going to fucking Rock on the Range where it's $11 for a 24-ounce yeah. Bud Light, dude.
You know that that's what you're going to spend.
Yeah. No, but that's what we had talked about, too, where it was like, oh, if we're going to buy these tickets, then we also need to know that I'm going to pay this much amount of money for all the beers that I'm going to fucking buy over the weekend.
And there's nothing like a good beer when you're at the thing that you're having fun at that you paid a bunch of money for. So if you account for the cost, it's like, yeah, even getting a beer at the zoo, it's like, God, I love this beer.
Yeah, just account for it. Like, if you can't do it, then don't fucking grab that beer. Like, just enjoy it fucking sober. But if you can afford to pay for that beer and you've made sure that you can, like, pay for that beer, then fucking get that $11, $7 fucking beer. Yeah. Like, do it.
Plus the zoo, you can definitely sneak some beer in. Just take a big-ass hydro flask or whatever.
Yeah, yeah.
Or a regular flask. Get that shit in the diaper bag.
Yeah, they don't check your body either.
Like, no, they don't check your body. I can put that shit in my back pocket. Maybe they would never even fucking know.
Titty flask, dude.
Dude, and all you have to do is just, like, stick your arm out to, like, to my face.
No, the ones that my mom had, they just, like, go in your bra, and I'll just take them out of my bra.
Oh. I'm thinking of the ones where it was, like.
Straw?
Yeah.
Like, you're sipping on our kid.
It was, like, the like, suit. It's a whole suit.
Yeah.
Oh, so, like, there's, like, the suit jacket has, like, a pouch on one of the sides. So you fill that up, and then it's got, like, a hose that runs up to the end of a pen. And so, like, you could be sitting there talking to your boss, but you're just, like,
sucking on a pen.
You're chewing on the end of the pen. Yeah. That's what they think that you're doing, but really, you're just sucking liquor through
until
that
you're
shit,
gulping,
dude.
Like.
Oh, I would be. No, yeah.
Are you drinking that ink?
Am I drinking right now? Yes. Yes, motherfucker. I am drinking right now.
You should give me a promotion for how clever this fucking, how much work I put into this.
How much work I put into being able to drink on the job, like, what's the word I'm looking for? Discreetly.
Yeah.
Like, you should just keep me hired on after that, you know?
I would just get, one of those purses where you can, fit, like, it has, like, a bag inside the purse, and you can fit a whole bottle of wine, like, in the bag.
Yeah.
And it's, like, a little spout on the outside of the purse, but I would just do, like, whatever the fuck you wanted in there.
Yeah.
Or we just do wine. Wine is a good.
No, because we could just do wine too. Like, I'd be cool with that. As long as I can get, like, a fucking buzz.
Do mimosas? Oh my gosh.
Oh, mimosas?
Just do, like, whole. Like, figure out what the size of the pack is that we have and, like, you know, create the portion of, like, mimosas for that. And then just do that. And then, like, we could both drink. I mean, I'm sure that you would like to, you know.
I guarantee that they would not ask if you had a camel pack on. Like, they wouldn't ask what's in it.
Dude, I'm just going to shove a whole bottle of something up my ass and then just walk through and then fucking shit that stuff out.
That's for enjoyment.
It is for a little bit of enjoyment, you know? Because I'm going to be like, oh, I'm sneaking shit past, but also like, oh, this feels so good on my asshole right now. Like, fuck, man.
A little R&R.
A little R&R.
I have bonus facts.
Before we end,
I do want to. So there's way more fake flamingos than real flamingos, obviously.
Just because
of the way those are produced. Like, obviously, people don't buy as many flamingos as there
as
are real
there
flamingos.
Are produced.
Yeah, so they just have a bunch of them in a warehouse. Yeah.
I'm mad about that, though, because that's wasteful.
It's fucked up. Yeah.
I mean, but this goes into the whole, like...
A lot of the facts have fucked up backstories.
Our production of shit compared to, like, what actually gets bought,
mm-hmm.
you know, is really fucked up. But yeah, for sure. It's because everybody wants their shit now. It's like, if you want... Like, if I want Velveeta mac and cheese tonight, you know, I can go to fucking Kroger and I can go get a box of it. Rather than being like, oh, I'm going to plan out what I want for the week and then order that.
And how much of that just gets thrown away? Or like, exactly. There's that video game.
It expires and then it gets thrown away.
There's that video game documentary on Netflix where they tell the story of how like Atari... Bless you. Bless you. How Atari went out of business, where like they made the E.T. video game and it was so terrible that nobody like fucking bought it, and then all the ones that they produced to go along with the movie and how big that was got put in a landfill in the fucking desert. And then that was like a big video game myth for a long time that actually turned out to be true, where they just shoved all these Atari carts in a fucking landfill in the desert.
Yeah,
like hundreds of thousands. Anyway, the name Jessica was invented by Shakespeare, and that's from Merchant of Venice, which that's absolutely true. He did invent that name.
Jessica.
Yeah, that wasn't a name until Shakespeare was just like, Jessica. And put it in one of his stories.
No fucking way,
Let's
dude.
Let's make the most annoying group of girls.
Yeah, he invented the worst white time, people.
But... No, but we've met a lot of fucking Jessicas that are really fucking annoying, though.
You know,
Jessica?
No, I haven't either.
I have never met a Jessica that I like. I dated a Jessica that I don't like. Yeah.
No.
Sorry, Jessica.
I can specifically think of two Jessicas that I know off the top of my head. And no, I don't like either one of them.
I used to like one, and then she hit me up on Facebook and was like, hey, girly.
No, you don't even have to continue it. Hey, girly gives me... Yeah. All that I need to know.
There you go, too.
That's a red flag.
Mm-hmm.
We already went over the Earth and Adams thing. Oxford University is older than the Aztec Empire. So teaching at that university started as early as 1096 the year. Like 1096. With many of the same tutors still teaching today. Not meaning like the people, but like the studies that were invented at that time, like that tutorage is still prestigious at that university.
Yeah.
Since that time. Whilst the Aztecs only really got into the swing of things with the founding of Tenochtitlan in 1325. So like 300 years later. So just to put the way we think about natives and history and time all in perspective.
Wait, what was the last one?
Oxford University is older than the Aztecs.
Okay, but you just said that the Aztecs were...
1325. Oxford University teaching started as early as 1096.
Really?
Yeah, like 250 years later, something like that.
Earlier, you mean?
Later.
Later.
The Aztecs happened. The Aztec Empire happened.
So how long... The Aztec Empire happened compared to
when the
what
Aztec...
was the fucking hold on what was the question?
The Aztec Empire is younger than Oxford University.
Is younger than Oxford University?
Yes.
So it's what
by
start...
about 250 years.
What started first?
Oxford University.
Okay, all right,
it's
I get
like
that now.
About one cigarette lighter.
I get it. I get it now. Yeah. See, I get it now.
Time is wibbly wobbly and confusing.
I get
it's
it
fine.
Now. No. I get it now. I don't know why it took me that long.
I struggle with time, too.
To
it's all
get
good.
It, but I got it now. I'm Gucci. I'm Gucci, bro. Okay. We're all Gucci here. All
right. Here's some bonus facts.
Yeah. Please give me the fucking bonus facts.
This is
you
just
know?
Shit that I learned
like,
while I was looking this up.
Suck my dick or something, dude. Like.
All right. So the dot. Wait, I have...
He was like, hold on, let me turn my soundboard on. I need to fuck some shit up.
I definitely have, like,
shit on my chest. It'll make me hard.
Oh, something. Yeah. What the fuck was that, though?
That's an audio-only early episode, for sure. I don't remember.
Shit on my chest. It'll make me hard. I remember saying it, but I don't remember what the fuck.
That's the case with a lot of these. Like, I don't remember the exact context.
I don't
remember
exactly when it fucking was, but it happened, though.
Okay, so the dot over the lowercase I, that is called, hell yeah. The dot over the lowercase I is called a tittle.
Yeah, a tittle.
Yeah, a tittle.
Yeah, a tittle.
Yeah. A tittle.
Oh, is this number three?
No, this is just bonus facts. This is unrelated. This is stuff I learned while making the game.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Saying Jesus backwards sounds like sausage.
Sausage? Sausage. Yeah. Yeah, it does, though.
It does.
You know? Uh-huh. It does.
I put that in there for that exact moment.
I played it up. It was like, you were like, oh, I know Austin's going to fucking do this shit. Yeah. Like, he's going to.
Sausage.
Gonna, yeah, sausage. Yeah. It does. It does, though.
Oh, Jesus.
Oh, Jesus.
Oh, yeah. Jesus. Yeah, I wonder how Jesus. He's doing. Yeah.
That's because, in...
All right, here we go.
Spanish Latino culture, it is... You're not gonna call somebody Jesus, because they're not Jesus.
Yeah.
They're Jesus.
Yeah.
You know, you're not gonna say Jesus. So, that's where that kind of, like, comes from, is that you're not gonna say Jesus, because they are not... Jesus.
Yeah.
Their name is Jesus.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Jesus.
Yeah. So that's why you, when you're talking about somebody's name, always say Jesus. Because it's not Jesus.
Unless you're in church, then it's Jesus. Talking about Jesus.
If you're talking, that's what I'm saying, though. That's what it just said.
But that's his name.
If you're talking about Jesus, then it's Jesus. But if you're talking about somebody that's not fucking Jesus, that's not what was written down in the Bible. Like, if you're talking to your friend and his name starts with J-E-S-U-S, is that how it's spelled? I don't even know, dude. How do you spell Jesus?
Yahweh.
J-E-S-U-S, right?
Yeah, sausage. Yeah.
It's Jesus.
Yeah.
Have you ever seen anybody's name?
Our Heavenly Father,
says,
who art in heaven.
And it's spelled out J-E-S-U-S.
Praise be to
Just
Jesus.
Know that it's Jesus.
Praise be to Jesus, amen.
Is it, no. Praise be to Jesus.
Oh, I thought
Jesus.
I was following you.
No. Praise be to Jesus. If you meet somebody that has the same
I'm a
spelling
follower.
Of that name, it's Jesus.
I'm a follower of Jesus.
You're a follower of Jesus, is what you are. You are not a follower of Jesus.
I am a follower of Jesus.
Name one Jesus that you've ever met in your entire life.
One Jesus?
Name one Jesus.
The one that listened to the podcast.
Oh, fuck yeah. Oh, shit.
Yeah, that's why I said I wonder how he's been.
I do wonder how he's fucking been. Yeah. Real talk.
How you been, bud? Anyway.
Is that your contact, dude?
Oh, it's not my contact.
She's like reorganizing her eyes right now.
Oh my
like,
god,
she...
dude. You haven't ordered your new ones yet, dude.
I didn't know. I was supposed to.
I told you to do that shit.
Every odd number has an E in it.
Do you look the opposite direction when you put that shit in? You were looking like up
opposite of
into
what?
The right. from your direction,
back
you
into
were,
the left.
From your direction, you were looking up into the right when you were putting your contact in.
Well, what was I supposed to be looking at?
The contact. Look straight.
I know a lot
That's
of people.
That's where it's going to settle in, is straight.
I can't.
I know
oh,
a lot of
can't?
People who put it
really?
On the whites of their eyes and then will like roll their eye down and it like settles on the pupil.
Oh fuck! Am I special? Is this another?
You're a
reason?
Little bit
is
special.
This another reason why I'm fucking special. We're like, I just go like this, dude. I make sure to pull my eyelashes back, and then I can just fucking clip it in there. I can. I
What's
look.
The name of that fucking. Movie?
I literally look at the contact as I put it in.
You
on both
clockwork,
my eyes, dude.
You a clockwork orange yourself?
Yeah, like, dude. Like, fuck yeah, dude. What's up? Oh, you want to put these on me? How do you do it?
Shut your eyes.
Shut my eyes.
Why are you shutting it so hard?
I didn't mean to, bro.
Why are your eyes wide shut?
You all do. Well, are you going to put it on or what, dude? I was, like, expecting you to put it on. Here.
The anticipation is killing them.
Yeah.
I want to look pretty.
I do want to look pretty.
Oh, you so pretty.
Dude.
You look like Boy George in the Culture Club.
I put on a fucking wig because she bought a wig one time.
Yeah.
And,
just jamming on there.
She put some makeup on me. And then, like, me putting on, like, a dress and shit, and I was like, damn, I'm a fucking bad bitch, bro. Yeah, like, yeah. I could definitely do drag, man. I think I could do drag. Yeah. Real talk. I think I could do drag and be like, fuck yeah.
We could pull off the movie
this
White
Chicks.
This
is crazy, because I can see the lashes. Can you see the lashes when you put them on?
Wear them long enough and your brain just writes them out of existence, though, yeah.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Really?
I mean, yeah.
Another fun fact. Related to this,
I mean, well, same thing with your nose.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah.
Yeah. You wear your nose long enough.
And it's
believed. You wear your nose long enough, and yeah, it just goes away.
It's believed that newborns up to like 2 months old hear like echoes, and it's just because the way the brain is wired, and it just has to write that
on right. Oh, okay.
The one is better than the other side, but it definitely looks good.
Just fucking make them right, though.
There you go. You look good. You fucking hot.
On the other one, it's fine, too.
Yeah, the other one's fine.
I'd fuck you.
The other one is fine.
I'm just talking about how I can see them.
Yeah, you're gonna be
yeah.
able to see
them.
Yeah,
I can see. It's like,
it's a
you know how, like, when on windshields, you know, how some of the windshields have, like, that sun blocker at the very top of of it? Yeah, that's what this feels like. It's crazy. This is what y'all see? I've never in my life.
This is like when I put on the spicy lip gloss and I'm like, what the fuck is wrong with you?
The spicy lip gloss.
Like, why do you guys do this to yourselves?
The spicy lip gloss.
Like, I don't get it.
But yes!
Yeah.
No, for real. Why do y'all, like, hurt yourselves to get,
heels,
like...
The weird fucking pants sizes, your
lips,
the fucking
dude.
Lip gloss.
I don't get any of...
Yeah.
Women's culture? I don't get it at all, dude. I really don't, man. All
right, Boy George.
I mean, yeah, call me whatever the fuck you want, dude. I don't give a shit. I don't get that shit. We're, like, literally...
Yeah.
A size, like, 4 at one company is completely different to another company. Yeah. But men's clothes...
It's just the measurement.
It's the fucking measurement.
Yeah.
So why don't they do the same thing with women's clothes? Why don't you do the same exact thing? What is the issue? What is the problem?
I don't know.
Men hate women.
Why do you have numbers?
It is all invented by men. That's
why do you have 0 through, like, whatever... What's the highest number y'all got? Do you know?
Triple F.
I mean,
no, it's not that. It's
it's the first thing I thought of.
I mean, 100% it goes into the 20s, but
it goes into the 20s?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, that, the 20s would be like
flappers
like
the start 2XL, of the
2XL, 3XL
okay.
around there.
Yeah.
And then yeah. And then it goes up from there. So not every company obviously will have, you know, eventually you'd get into sizes where you, your options, it's definitely harder. Even for me, going from, like, before I had Amelia, I was, like, where I just wore regular sizes. I didn't wear plus sizes, like, nothing. And now I'm kind of, like, in between. So, like, sometimes I can wear, like an extra large, but then I could also sometimes wear like a 1X, so it's like very much like in the middle. So like there are some stores where like low-key I can't shop there anymore because I really just don't have my size. And certain things like thrift stores, like it's really hard for like plus size people to
you
find
shop
things.
There. Yeah.
Yeah, so you kind of have to shop online for realsies.
No, I think it should all be like universal.
Mm-hmm.
Like, yeah. Oh, okay. So it's the same thing as like if you a lot of men's button-up shirts, like the high-end like button-up shirts, are Chinese made. So they go off of their style. So like Chinese men compared to like U.S. men are a lot like shorter.
Yeah.
And smaller. than we are. Yeah. And that's just like from like genetics and like DNA and everything else. So
I believe you more when you have the eyelashes on.
I'm glad that you do.
Yeah.
So for something like us in like America that's normally like a medium, it's going to be like a double XL or an XL in a Chinese made button up shirt.
Yeah.
You know, so like that's what you can you please take these off though? Like no, I can I can see it though, and
you look adorable.
It's bothering the shit out of me though.
You look totes adorbs.
I really don't understand how y'all do it. I really don't.
It is fun to play dress up and experience it though.
I mean, I would. I've
this off of your left eye.
Yeah. Yeah. We haven't. You did my makeup.
Yeah, but I don't think I did fake eyelashes.
I'm not even talking about. But, did you do my makeup and the wig though, or did you just do my makeup and then it was?
And the wig.
You did my makeup and the wig.
Yeah, can I show us a picture?
Please.
Yeah, please. Yeah. No. Yeah. Of course. Dude, I felt fucking hot, man.
Yeah, I'm sure you were. I did. You looked hot.
I did, man. Yeah. She did my makeup. I put the wig on, man. I was like, oh my god, like I'm a fucking bad bitch, dude. What do you mean?
Yeah.
Like I'll fucking smack a motherfucker.
Did you see on YMH that they dressed Christina up?
Oh, yeah, I did. I did, actually. I fucking did. In prosthetics and everything, dude.
Yeah.
They went all out on that shit.
They made her up like Trish.
Did you watch the live show, though?
I haven't bought it yet. I've bought two out of the, like, five that they've done so far, so I need to catch up on the new three. They're great. They're worth purchasing. Hell yeah. While you're finding that, I got a few facts to finish up.
Oh, yeah. Get on the facts, bro.
Every odd number has an E in it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I knew that, actually. I did know that.
It's a fun little, like, you start running through the numbers.
It's just something random that I fucking know.
Yeah.
I hate that.
That's why I made the game, useless stuff.
But I hate that about myself, is that, like, there was, during that game, I was like, oh, I know the answer to this one, like... I hate that I know that random facts, but, like, I literally cannot tell you what I had for breakfast.
Yeah. I'm the same way, man. I know the most useless shit.
The day before.
Yeah.
You know, like, I fucking hate that shit, but I can, when somebody's, like, ask me a question, I can be like, oh, I know the fucking answer to that.
Mm-hmm. There are more public libraries in the U.S. than there are McDonald's, which I'm proud of that one. Good job. We're doing something right.
There are more public libraries than there are McDonald's.
I had to look it up to double check. Yeah.
Fucking awesome, dude. Yeah, we're doing good. No, yeah. That is fucking awesome, dude.
It's something to feel good about.
McDonald's is like, there's one on every fucking corner, dude.
Yeah.
That's.
Now when I see the flag, I feel just a tiny bit less bad.
No, dude, no. When I see a public library, that makes me feel a tiny bit better, dude. I'm like, fuck yes.
Yep.
That's awesome. That is so fucking awesome. Even though, as we all know, I'm somebody who doesn't read books.
Yeah.
But I still enjoy
it. It's good that the access to knowledge is there.
Is the yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
We're doing something right.
Yes, it is. Fuck, man. That made me happy as fuck,
I'm
dude.
I'm glad.
Yeah.
I hand-selected these ones just to be not put in the game, but just because I liked them.
Hell yeah, man.
1,000 seconds is about 16 minutes.
1,000 seconds is about 16 minutes?
1,000,000 seconds is about 11 days. This is more of the exponential stuff I was talking about.
Yeah.
1,000,000,000 seconds
uh-huh.
is about 32 years.
Damn. So the jump from 1,000,000 to 1,000,000,000 is like days to years.
Yes.
Damn.
Yeah.
It makes sense, though.
1,000,000,000 is a fucking lot.
Yeah. It makes sense, though. When you know what, like, 1,000 to 1,000,000,000 is, or even, like, 100,000 to 1,000,000,000.
1,000,000,000 is 1,000, is 1,000, no, is it 100,000?
100.
A billion is 100,000 millions or something stupid. Like, I think I'm saying that wrong, or it's one of those.
Okay, so hold it on. Would be. Hold on. Let's break this down. Break it down. Okay, so you have your thousands. They go into 100,000s.
Yeah,
and so once you get to 900,000, after that you get to
1,000,000.
A million.
Yeah.
Okay, that's just a million.
So they can go 10 million, 100 million, 999, 100 million.
And then to a billion.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So yeah, 100 billions was right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah. All right. Or no, it would be 1,000 millions is a billion.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's the way to say it.
No, yeah. Not 900,000 million.
We'll figure it out. It's fine.
900,000 million.
It would be more.
999.
You would have to say it as a one number, which is why I went from saying 100 millions or 100,000 millions to saying.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, you see what I'm saying?
Yeah. No. We get where we're.
Math is hard.
All
right, here
especially
we go.
When you get into those large numbers. Okay, so
I think I sent it to you.
What?
I think I sent you those pictures. At some point,
what pictures?
Of you with the makeup.
All right, while he's looking for it, I'll tell you more facts.
Of me, what?
Of you dressed up and makeup and stuff.
No, you definitely did.
Pluto.
I got you. All right. Yeah, no, I got you.
Pluto, the planet that's no longer a planet. Never made a full orbit around the sun from the time it was discovered to the time it was called no longer a planet.
Wait, hold on. No, say that again. Hold on, I didn't hear it.
So Pluto didn't make one full orbit around the sun
uh-huh.
from the time it was discovered to the time it was called no longer a planet. It takes forever for Pluto to orbit the fucking sun.
So, yes?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Humans... Oh, here's some banana facts. Humans share 50% of their DNA with bananas. And a strawberry isn't a berry, but a banana is. And so are avocados. Those are also berries. And watermelons are also technically berries. Dude, so bananas, watermelons, and avocados are all berries, but strawberries are not.
Hold on. Say that for me one more time.
Strawberries?
You asked me to look for something. Anyway.
Strawberries are not berries. Bananas, avocados, and watermelons technically are berries.
Yes. But strawberries aren't?
No.
Really?
Yeah.
So what are...
Well, I guess I'd have to look that up.
So what are strawberries then? Wait, no. If you're going to come in with that fucking information
it was
like
the
that,
one that I didn't
have.
Then
you gotta be like, oh, I got the backup information for that. Like, don't...
It doesn't take me long.
What the fuck, dude?
A berry is an indehiscent, not splitting apart at maturity, is what indehiscent means. So it doesn't split apart at maturity. It's a fruit derived from a single ovary and having a whole wally flesh. Berries are not all tiny and they're not all sweet. Surprisingly, eggplants, tomatoes, avocados, bananas are botanically classified as berries, and strawberries are not berries at all.
Yeah. Okay. All right. That makes sense, though. That just makes sense. But... On that note,
it's that time.
Yeah, it is that time. So, glad to have you back, man. I'm glad
that
to have
was
you
fun,
here.
Dude.
I fucking love you, man.
I love you too, man. I love you guys so much.
I.
Yeah.
I can't thank you enough for everything. Like,
I know.
With our relationship.
Yeah.
And, you know, all
we
that
didn't really
shit.
Talk
like,
about it, but this week's been a fucking roller coaster.
It's been
the past 4 weeks have. Yeah,
it's been some fucked up shit.
Yeah,
like real talk. And I told you this in the Discord. You don't have to worry about that, babe. Don't worry about it. But no, man. You help me understand what's going on with my everyday life and help me keep myself grounded, and I appreciate it. I love that, you know, I have that relationship with you, and you make me have that perspective on things, and help me understand that's like what's going on in my life and stuff like that, as crazy as it fucking has been.
Yeah.
So like I really appreciate it, and I love that I'm truly blessed to have you as like my best friend, man.
Thanks, man.
Yeah. Like, same. Seriously.
Yeah.
I'm glad that you feel the same way, man. Like, and I think that, you know, we're both on the same spectrum of that type of relationship, you know? And it's special. I'm glad that we have that, man. Seriously. Yeah. I mean, whatever. But nah, seriously, man, I'm glad that we have the relationship that we have, and it is what it is. Like, it definitely helps me out with my everyday life. So
I'm glad to. If I help you out in any way, then fuck yeah. And
hell yeah, I hope same for you, man. Yeah. If I help you out in, you know, in your everyday life. I know that you overthink shit too, because you said that to me recently, and I was like, man, I even told you before that I had a blast with the gaming shit, and you were like, I thought that, like, something. Yeah. I was like, well, I already told you, but I get it, though. I really do, because I went through a lot of shit this past week, too. So
I was just worried about you.
And I'm glad, though. Yeah. I'm glad that you were, because I was, you know, a lot of shit had happened. Went through a lot of shit. Went through a lot of feelings, and still trying to process all of that shit, too.
Yeah.
But I'm just glad that I have you as somebody that I can talk to, and Logan, actually, too.
Yeah.
Logan's been somebody that's been checking up on me with the events that have been happening in the past couple weeks. And I really appreciate that shit. Like, that means more to me than anything.
Yeah, he's good people.
He is a really good person, man. Yeah. I really do love Logan. Playing games with him sometimes, when he gets tilted.
He has a dark side.
When he gets tilted, it can be bad.
Yeah.
But you know that, like, if you need somebody there for you, that motherfucker will be there for you. Like, outside of video games, you know that motherfucker would be there for you. Like,
for sure.
And that's what I love about him. That's, you know, the real talk.
Yeah.
So, thank you guys so much for fucking listening to this episode. If anybody's still here on Twitch, or if you're listening on YouTube, which you can listen on YouTube, just search Blue Skies from the Basement.
Yep.
You know?
There's going to be more content coming soon up there. Yep.
Oh, yeah. I already did our donation plugs. Yeah. So I'm going to go ahead and skip those, because if you're still listening by this point, you already know where to find our donation shit at.
You can go to bluesguysfromthebasement.podbean.com to find all those links as well. That's our home base. That's where all the links are.
Oh, or even on Spotify.
Yep.
Or Apple Podcasts. Just go into the description of any fucking episode that you go to, and those links will be there.
Scroll down to the bottom.
To go into our Discord, to our Facebook, to our Venmo, our PayPal, you know.
Cash App.
The Cash App.
Twitter, Facebook, Instagram.
Yeah. Yep. All those links are there in the description of Spotify, Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, whatever it is that you listen
to. TuneIn, iHeartRadio. Or YouTube. We're on Amazon Music now. We're on all that shit. Yep.
Even YouTube, you know. If you go to YouTube, all those links are down in there. So there's plenty of ways for you guys to find us. You just got to go and kind of search us out. We don't really have to say it every single fucking time.
Yeah.
But we also do have merch out on tpublic.com/BSFTB. And that is the number one way to find out, like, what we've been recently putting out for our logos and, you know, stuff like that. So, and they have everything from t-shirts to tapestries to laptop cases to mugs, like
stickers, all sorts of stickers.
Yeah. There's plenty of shit that you can find out on there. tpublic.com/BSFTB.
Yep.
You can find our merch on there.
Kind of an underutilized feature of the show, too, is that you can write us at our email, which is blueskiespodcast@gmail.com, or you can call in, and you can do any of that anonymously, or let us know if you want your name said, tell us a story, ask us a question. Eventually, I think it's a good idea for us to put out, like, prompts and have people call in and give us answers.
Yeah.
Kind of like that TikTok we watch of the dude who put out, like, an ad to be a cat or something.
Yeah, that was fucking hilarious.
If you guys
put it up on a fucking poll, dude.
Yep, so if you want to participate in the show, there's always the hotline or the email, and the voicemail line is 614-600-2056. You can call in, let us know your thoughts, tell us a story, ask a question, whatever you want to do. I love that we have that, and you guys need to use it more.
600-2056. You can call or text.
Yeah, that too.
Or text. Send us a text or send us an email at blueskiespodcast@gmail.com.
Yep.
Like, one of those two. tell us your fucking stories. If you hear or your opinion on something that you heard us talk about and you have your own opinion and maybe you're bringing a different perspective or something like that, like, we love hearing that shit. We love hearing how other people perceive the world. That helps us be better people in our own lives and understand how other people can have a different perspective on their lives, and to be able to feel that and to be able to talk to other people. It's all about a learning experience. So, like, we talk about a lot of, like, kind of serious shit on our podcast too, as much as we try and be like an uplifting, like, happy podcast.
Yeah, we skipped some stuff this week too.
Yeah, we did. We definitely did. Yeah. But we do talk about some serious shit sometimes.
We'll get to it.
And so, like, if you have, you know, a certain perspective on that or a certain feeling on that, and you think that you could bring a different perspective to that situation, call, leave a voicemail, or leave an email, or leave a text, so we can, like, understand where you're coming from and maybe have a different perspective. We want to grow, too.
Yeah.
We don't want to be, you know, somebody that's not understanding of the world. We want to understand the world. We want to understand and be the most compassionate to other people. And we are a comedy podcast, too, so we make fucking jokes. So if you ever have an issue with a joke that we make and you feel like you're offended, you know, feel free to write into us, too. And let us know, like, how that offended you. And know that, like, we're doing this out of a comedy standpoint. We're not trying to offend anybody. But if it does offend you, then, you know, we apologize. And that we are doing this out of the fun of making comedy for people. And we know that that can be subjective
yeah.
to certain people. So if it is something that offends you, then let us know. And then we can kind of, you know, go from there. But also just know that we are a comedy podcast and we make fucking jokes. You know, this is something that I've talked to people about recently. And I just want people to know, like, kind of where we stand.
Yeah, for sure.
This is a comedy show. We are not science and technology. Yeah.
We make it super easy for you to let us know, too. So,
there's plenty of outlets for you to, like, let us know how you fucking feel.
So, go ahead and do that.
So, do it.
Yep.
Don't be a fucking bitch. Do it. You know, if you're listening this far into an episode, fucking do it.
Yeah.
But thank you so much for listening. I know that all three of us love you guys.
Yes.
You know.
We love you.
Thank you for everything. And, yeah. Matoko, I fucking love you, dude. No worries, dude. No fucking worries.
Peace, dude.
See you, man. Hey, everybody have a good fucking weekend. We love you guys. Later.
It's the best part. Never mind again. I'm not eating anymore of this.